Mike the Unicorn! And today, we're gonna take a look at the optimal graphics settings for Call of Duty Modern Warfare on PC. Okay, so we're just gonna jump straight into the meat of the content, and I'm gonna tell you the recommended settings. You will want to put display mode on full screen, display monitor, choose your monitor, display adapter, choose your GPU, screen refresh rate, put the refresh rate of your monitor here. If it's 240 Hz, you put 240. If it's 144 Hz, you put 144. Render resolution 1920 by 1080 is what I recommend for the best FPS and a smooth looking game. On advanced here, you should check that it is the same as the render resolution. Aspect ratio, put that on automatic. VSync disabled. Custom frame rate limit, you can have that on unlimited, but I put it on custom. Then I go to advanced, and I have auto focus custom frame rate limit at 30 and menu custom frame rate limit at 60. So when you have that on 60, you will like relieve your GPU of some stress when it doesn't need to be pushing to the max. So I would have that on 60, that on 30, put that on 300. NVIDIA highlights should be disabled. If you for some reason use the NVIDIA highlights to record in the background or stuff like that, you can have that enabled, but it will take some frames away from you, so I have that disabled. Display gamma should be chosen automatically. Most TN displays are 2.2 sRGB, so that is what I am doing right there. Texture resolution should be put on high or normal, because if you have that on very low, you can have that on very low if you want like absolute all the frames that you can get out of the game. But it doesn't punish you that much to have it on normal or high, but it looks a lot better. There is an example, right? You see the difference between this and that. So I recommend having that on normal or high so things look better, right? Texture filter should be put on low, particle quality low, bullet impacts and sprays. I have that enabled. It doesn't really matter if you have it disabled or enabled because it doesn't impact your performance. Tessellation disabled, shadow map resolution on low, cache spot shadows enabled, cache sun shadows enabled. This will actually help you speed up rendering for future frames, so it's really good to have that enabled. Particle lightning, put that on low. DirectX disabled. Ambient occlusion disabled. Screen space reflection disabled. This one should be put on either SMAA 1X or T2X. I have it on this setting because it looks a lot better. When you have that off, everything looks edgy and like jagged. And when you move around, the lines keep moving in a weird pattern. So this kind of smooth everything out and makes it look a lot better. And it doesn't really impact performance that much. So I have it left on this one. The Filmic SMAA is a little bit too much. It starts to look like too soft for my taste, so I have it on SMAA T2X. That is the best one of all of these. Anyway, depth of field disabled, filmic strength put to 0, world motion blur disabled, weapon motion blur disabled, film grain on 0. The reason for that is that you want everything to be smooth while you're moving around. Your brain makes kind of a motion blur thing, and it also makes a blur when you're focusing on different stuff, so it's no point in having depth of field or world motion blur or weapon motion blur enabled, because it's just blur on top of your brain's blur, and you want everything to be as clear as possible, so when you do a 180 to shoot at someone, you can quicker find your target and point and shoot in the right, at the right spot, right? So that is my recommended settings. If you want the most frames, no matter what the cost is, if the game looks really shit, then you should put everything on low. It's really just texture resolution on very low, and you should have bullet impacts disabled, even though it doesn't do much, and you should put this on off. Then you're secure that you will get the most frames per second. But when I have these things on, I have a much better like visual on the target, and I think that it's worth it. Even though I'm losing 15 frames, around 15 frames per second, I think it's worth it because I am more spot on with my target, right? So I would really recommend having this on high and putting this on SMAA T2X. You can play around with it. If it punishes you too much, you can put it on SMAA 1X, and you can maybe have texture resolution on normal and see if that is something that you can live with. But I wouldn't put everything on very low unless you're really, really in need for those 15 extra frames that you get by doing that. So if you have any questions, put them in the comment section down below. In the next video, we're going to talk about audio.
Mike the Unicorn out.
No, my name is Michael. I'm a motherfucking psycho. I might roll a fine joint because the ganja is my Bible. And the devil is the 5-0. They track me on my iPhone from distance where I go. Taking pictures of my final. I'm a motherfucking loony. I should have my own movie like Forrest Gump. With a motherfucking doobie. Feeling funky and groovy. Till the cops come up and shoot me on the block that I'm living in.